हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्या प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौर भक्त वृंदा जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्या प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौर भक्त वृंदा हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपी कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदानेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय बोलो श्री राधे गोलोकानंद भगवान की
जय।
हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। For Srimad Bhagavatam, that's the best thing to read, right? And so we had planned to do quiz today, isn't it? So are we ready for that?
We're never ready for tests, right?
Yeah, I don't think anyone has prepared or read through anything during this weekend, right? Everyone was so busy. Actually, I myself was also overbooked this weekend. So, didn't get a chance to prepare the quiz. So, I think everyone is spared good. for today.
good for us then.
Yeah. So, I think we'll give one more weekend. What about that? Yeah. So, next Monday, I will do the overview and quiz for Canto 2. At that time, just try to read through all the text and all that. Shouldn't take long time. Should be 1 or 2 hours. We'll give a good overview and then, we'll do a nice quiz. And quiz is nothing but just an overview, right? So that we all can just not forget what we have read and continue to build on that. So let's start. We were on shloka 31 of Adhyay 1 and Canto 3, of course. So, and if you just quickly remember, Vidur Maharaj, Mahatma Vidur, meets Udhavji at Yamuna Nadi, right? And we know both are great devotees of Lord Sri Krishna. And so there is a great conversation happening between them before Mahatma Vidur meets Maitreya Muni. And so once he meets Udhavji, Vidur, Mahatma Vidur, because he has been out for so long from Hastinapur, he is asking all these questions, सारे प्रश्न कर रहे हैं उद्धव जी से, कृष्ण भगवान कैसे हैं, युधिष्ठिर कैसे हैं, अर्जुन कैसे हैं, so that's what is going on right now, yeah. So let's read 31, Anil ji.
एमं सकच्चिद्यु युधान आस्ते यह फाल्गुनाल लब्ध धनु रहस्यः लेवे अंज साधोक्ष जैसे वयेवा गतिम तदीयाम यति विर्दु दुरापाम ओ उद्धव दस युधना फेयरवेल ही लर्न द इंट्रिकेसीज ऑफ द मिलिट्री आर्ट फ्रॉम अर्जुन एंड अटेन्ड द ट्रांसेंडेंटल डेस्टिनेशन व्हिच इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रीच इवन फॉर ग्रेट रिनाउंसर्स.
Hare Krishna, right? So great renouncers, like people who give up everything, take sannyas and do become Mahatma, right? Even they cannot attend the transcendental destination, which is referred here as Adhokshaj. That's called Adhokshaj. That is a destination. But Yudhana, he could get to that destination. So Mahatma Vidur is asking Udhavji, how is he? And then this purport has a lot of good knowledge in this. So we are going to read this. Shivam?
The destination of transcendence is to become the personal associate of the personality of Godhead, who is known as Adhoksaja, who is beyond the reach of the senses, the renouncers of the world, the sannyasis, give up all worldly connections, namely family, wife, children, friends, home, wealth, everything to attain the transcendental bliss of Brahman happiness. But Adhoksaja happiness is based on Brahman happiness, is beyond Brahman happiness. The empiric philosophers enjoy a transcendental quality of bliss by philosophical speculation on the supreme truth. But beyond that pleasure is the pleasure enjoyed by Brahman in his eternal form of the personality of Godhead. Hare Krishna.
Well, let's continue to read this. Karun?
Brahman bliss is enjoyed by living entities of liberation from material bondage. But Parabrahman, the personality of Godhead, enjoys eternally a bliss of his own potency, which is called the Haladini potency. The empiric philosopher who studies Brahman by negation of the external features has not yet learned the quality of the Haladini potency of Brahman. Out of many potencies of the omnipotent, there are three features of his internal potency, namely Samvit, Sandhini, and Hladini. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So the reason we read this paragraph is to really understand three internal potencies of Lord Sri Krishna. Yeah. And as you know, Supreme Lord has internal potency, there's an external potency, right? And marginal potency. Right, internal potency is all the spiritual, external potency by which the material world is generated, and the marginal potency is in between, right? The the soul and the consciousness, right, which generates. But here, what is mentioned is, out of many potencies of the omnipotent, there are three features of his internal potency, and namely Samvit, Sandhini, and Hladini. Yeah. So Samvit, so actually. Sandhini refers to the eternal existence of the Lord, the eternal existence of the whole thing, right? And out of which we know like 3/4 is the spiritual world, and the remaining 1/4 is the, what's the remaining 1/4?
Material world.
Material world, right? So as we can see, the spiritual world, which is the Vaikunth sky, is 3/4, as we have talked about it before. And the only 1/4 is this material world. And even our universe is a very small universe, and there are innumerable number of universes like this, and that is only 1/4 of the, and that aspect of the Lord Sri Krishna's internal potency is called Sandhini. And then the next is Samvit. Samvit is refers to the cognizant or knowledge. Yeah. So the knowledge of everything is the Samvit aspect of the internal potency of the Lord. And the most important is the Hladini, which is the bliss, right? That's how you experience the bliss. And that is the, like Radha Rani experiences that, right? That's the bliss. So those are the three aspects of the three features of the internal potency of the Lord Sri Krishna. Yeah. And that's for the quiz of Canto 3. We are reading Canto 3 right now. So, yeah, it's just good to know that. And I think we'll probably read more about that later on. Let's just finish the purport of this, Mayur.
And in spite of their strict adherence to the principles of Yama, Niyama, Asana, Dhyana, and Dharana, and Pranayama, the great yogis and yajnas are unable to enter into the internal potency of the Lord. This internal potency is, however, easily realized by the devotees of the Lord by dint of devotional service. Yuyodhana achieved this stage of life just as he achieved expert knowledge in military science from Arjun. Thus, his life was successful to the fullest extent from both the material and spiritual angels of vision. That is the way of devotional service to the Lord. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? What is mentioned here? Who cannot achieve the internal potency, right? Even if people who have sacrificed everything, doing a lot of austerities, kafi tapasya kar rahe hain, and they are big yogis, they get to the higher planets, definitely, but even they cannot realize the internal potency of the Lord. However, easily realized, easily, very important, easily realized by the devotees of the Lord, by dint of devotional service. What is devotional service? Like what we are chanting, surrendering to Lord Sri Krishna, reading Srimad Bhagavatam. And you know, we have this Rasikshyam Prabhuji here, Hare Krishna Prabhuji. So, you know, like chanting 16 rounds, but at least we should start with one round, two round, three rounds, whatever we can do on a daily basis. And with that, the Lord himself reveals by himself, as we do more and more devotional service, Lord Sri Krishna reveals himself and reveals his internal potency. So let's continue reading, Anisha.
Kachit Buddha Swastyanamiva Aste Shwafalka Putro Bhagavat Prapannaha यह कृष्ण पादांग कित मार्गम पासु पासु श्व चेष्टत प्रेम विभिन्न धैर्यः. प्लीज टेल मी वेदर अक्रूरा द सन ऑफ स्वफलका इज डूइंग वेल. ही इज अ फॉल्टलेस सोल सरेंडर्ड अनटू द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड. ही वंस लॉस्ट हिज मेंटल इक्विलिब्रियम ड्यू टू द SST of transcendental love and fell down on the dust of the road, which was marked with the footprints of Lord Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right. So such is the devotion. Yeah. Such is the devotion. SST of transcendental love. He saw the footprints of Lord Sri Krishna and fell down on the dust of the road. Right. Very nice purport, Soham.
When Akura came to Vrindavan in search of Krishna, he saw the footprints of the Lord on the dust of Nanda Grama, and I once fell on them in ecstasy of transcendental love. The ecstasy is possible for a devotee who is fully absorbed in incessant thoughts of Krishna. Such a pure devotee of the Lord is naturally faultless because he is always associated with the supremely pure personality of Godhead. Constant thought of the Lord is the antiseptic method of keeping oneself free from the infections, contamination of the material qualities. The pure devotee of the Lord is always in company with the Lord by thinking of him. Yet in the particular context of time and place, the transcendental emotions take a different turn, and this breaks as the mental equilibrium of the devotee. Lord Chaitanya displayed a typical example of transcendental ecstasy, as we can understand from the life of incarnation. God, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? The important aspect in this paragraph is constant thought of the Lord is the antiseptic method for keeping oneself free from the infectious contamination of the material qualities. Like 24 hours, we are in this touch of the material world with all this material thinking, different kinds of thinking, right? Even Satogun or Rajogun or Tamogun. But what is the antiseptic for that? For that is the constant thought of the Lord. And it's, you know, at different times, it's very nicely explained. How can you be in constant touch with Sri Krishna always, right? Ajay?
Kachit Shiva Devak Bhoj Putriya Vishnu Prajaya Iv Dev Matuh Yavai Swarg Swarg Swag Bhen Dadhar Devam यत्री यथा यज्ञ वितान मर्थम. As the Vedas are the reservoir of sacrificial purposes, so the daughter of King Devaka Bhoja conceived the Supreme Personality of Godhead in her womb and did the mother of the demigods. Is she Devaki doing well? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So now, who is asking this?
Vidur.
Vidurji, right? Mahatma Vidur. And asking whom? Udhavji, right? River. Vidur Mahatma meets Udhavji. Now, because Vidur Mahatma has been in the pilgrimage, right? So he has been like away. So now he's asking all this to Udhavji, who knows everything. And so Vishnu Prajaya. Who is Vishnu Prajaya? In this case, he's Devaki, right? Lord Krishna is the son of Devaki, right? So now Vidur Mahatma is asking, how is Devaki, right? Ravi, you can read.
The Vedas are full of transcendental knowledge and spiritual values. And thus Devaki, the mother of Lord Krishna, conceived the Lord in her womb as the personified meaning of the Vedas. There is no difference between the Vedas and the Lord. The Vedas aim at the understanding of the Lord, and the Lord is the Vedas personified. Devaki is compared to the meaningful Vedas and the Lord of their purpose personified. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Sachin?
अपि स्विदास्ते भगवान सुखं वो यह सात्वताम कामो दुधो निरुध यमा मनिंति स्म ही शब्द योनि ही योनिम मनोमयम सत्व तुरियत्तत्वम. May I inquire whether Aniruddha is doing well? He is the fulfiller of all the desires of the pure devotees and has been considered from yore to be the cause of the Rig Veda, the creator of the mind and the fourth plenary expansion of Vishnu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right? Now, Vidur Mahatma is inquiring about Aniruddha, who is the fulfiller of all the desires of the pure devotees. Yeah. Api Svidaste Bhagwan Sukham Vo. So now, he is inquiring about, actually, let's read this. Tarun.
Adi Katur Bhuja. The original expansions from Baldev are Vasudeva, Sankarsana, Pradyumna, and Aniruddha. All of them are Vishnu Tattvas or non-different personalities of Godhead. In the incarnation of Sri Rama, all these different expansions appeared for particular pastimes. Lord Rama is the original Vasudeva, and his brothers were Sankarsana, Pradyumna, and Aniruddha. Aniruddha is also the cause of Mahavishnu, from whose breathing the Rig Veda appeared. All this is nicely explained in the Markandeya Purana. In the incarnation of Lord Krishna, Aniruddha appeared as the son of the Lord. Lord Krishna in Dwarka is the Vasudeva expansion of the original group. The original Lord Krishna never leaves Goloka Vrindavana. All the plenary expansions are one and the same Vishnu Tattvas, and there's no difference in their potency. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So we have Lord Sri Krishna and Baldev, and original expansions are like you have Vasudev, Sankarsan, Pradyumna, and Aniruddha. And you'll read about those more as we go. And they appeared at Ram, Bharat, Shatrudha, Lakshman, Shatrughan, yeah, during Ramayana. Ravi?
Yes. Api svidandye cha nijatma deva manya vritaya samundra vritaya ye hrudi kasya majat charuna deshuna gada daya swasti charanti somya. O sober one, other such as Radhika, Charu, Deshna, Gada, and the son of Satyabhama, who accept Lord Krishna as the soul of the self and thus follow his path without deviation, are they well? Hare Krishna.
So Mahatma Adu continues to ask about everyone here.
दो भार्याम विजयाच्युताभ्याम धर्मेण धर्म परिपाति सेतुं दुर्योधनो तप्यत यत सभायाम साम्राज्य लक्ष्म्या विजयानुवृत्त्या. Also, let me inquire whether the Maharaj Yudhishthir is now maintaining the kingdom according to the religious principle and with respect of the path of religion. Formerly, Duryodhan was burning with envy because Yudhishthir was being protected by the arm of Krishna and Arjuna as if they were his own arms.
Hare Krishna. Right? So now, inquiring about even Maharaj Yudhishthir. Kim va krita deshu dhamatyamarshi bhimo avidirdhatamam vyamuchyate yashangrim patam ranabhunasehe marga gadaya chaksharato vichitram. Soham?
Please tell me whether the uncurable Bhima, who is like a cobra, has released a long-cherished anger upon the sinners. The field of battle could not tolerate even the wonderful playing of his club when he stepped on the path. Hare Krishna.
Right. So now he's inquiring about Bhima. So I think this will continue. Tomorrow I think we'll complete this adhyaya and we'll then go to the next. We'll stop now since we still have Navaratri going on, right? And very auspicious Navaratri. We have been listening to Vaishnava Devi's live prayers from, 13th April. We'll continue to hear that, yeah? And Rasik Shyam Prabhuji, if you want to say anything before that.
Ram Navami is also approaching by tomorrow, and it is the end of 9th day fasting. So we have to be fully conscious of Lord Ram and pray for him, pray to him for our spiritual advancement, and at the same time pray for all Jivatmas during COVID time. Yes. That's all.
Yeah, no. Thank you, Rasik Shyam Prabhuji. That's on Wednesday. So, and we'll definitely hear Ram Kirtan on that day. So, let's continue with Vaishnava Devi prayers and then we'll see you tomorrow. Okay? Hare Krishna.
Jaya Naga Vidhara Jini Doka. Amen.